Hello, this is Zenith here, and this is our capstone project, eRent. It is a React app, basically, where users can contact the seller and choose any room which they like. Okay, so let me quickly take you through the features. This is our landing page, where the different properties are listed. This is our footer. We have implemented pagination as well. But before that, let me quickly take you through the login section, login page. Now, for Google login and normal login, we have used Firebase and Firestore. And since I'm already an existing user, so I will log in with my Google credentials. So before that, I would also like to show one thing, like if I give some wrong details, like wrong credentials. And try to log in, then you can see that a pop-up message arrives where it says that there is no user record corresponding to this identifier. So we have implemented a wrong alert model. Okay, so now I will log in with my correct credentials. See, so since I'm already logged in, now profile is shown. So for profile, before going to profile, I'll just quickly take you through a little more features. Like I'll just show the pagination, how it works. So we have implemented pagination. Like you can see page 1, 2. So if we go to page 2, a lot of features are listed here, a lot of properties are listed here as well, right? So okay, now let me show you how the filter thing works. So like you can see, we can filter by any location. Say we search Kota, then like Bangalore, then only Bangalore based things will be shown. See only Bangalore. It was not loading due to some reason. Now it's showing. See, Hyderabad. Since I have given the location as Hyderabad, so Hyderabad is shown. If I give Bangalore, then you can see that Bangalore thing is shown, right? So this is how the filter works. Next feature is if we go, we can, you know, I'll just take you to the profile. So if we go to the profile, like you can see here is you know, features, like all the properties, like after login, whichever I have used. So if I just, you know, remove any one of them, I can do that as well, because we can delete the properties as well. So I'll just remove this one, quota. See, it's absolutely working fine. Now we will quickly go to the sell product page. Just a second. Taking time to load. So for saving the time, I have already, you know, already filled up all the details. So I'll just quickly post and now and check whether it's working fine or not. See, there's a confirmation message as well. Successfully posted, confirmation mail have sent. So now let me go to the landing page and check. So let me just check whether the landing page, whether the property has been posted or not. See, it has been posted. Now if we go to the if you want to go to single page, we can do that as well by clicking on each card. So here you can see that all the specific details about this particular property are listed here. Also, we have implemented map, which is static for now, but we will add dynamic map soon. We have implemented the chat as well. So by clicking on this chat button, we redirect to the chat page, right? So this chat page is also static for now. In future, we will add chat features. Now, let me just take you through the responsive part of the app. I'll just again go to that single page. So like you can see, it's responsive. Now, if I go to this, like if I just, you know, click this, this is also responsive. Like you can see. If we log out and check if the login page is responsive or not. It's taking a bit time. Also, so yeah, our login page also, you can see that it's responsive. Oh, it hasn't loaded yet. Just a second. So like you can see, the footer is absolutely responsive. And so is the login page. Also another thing which I forgot to tell, like in the login page, there's a panel for both, like the existing users will log in, and who aren't the existing users, they can register. So we have a panel for, you know, full name, mobile number, email, password, and confirm password. So that is all about our app, eRent. And also a few things which I would like to tell, that for storing images, we have used Cloudinary. We have used React for building the user interface. We have used Redux for state management. For making the app responsive, we have used Flexbox, Grid. And for making, for storing the images, we have used Cloudinary. And finally, we deployed our app on Heroku. Yeah, so thank you. That's all.